Okay. Now we come to a completely new topic. We had been dealing with the straight lines. Now we'll be dealing with planes. Okay? And these planes are in space. So you understand? So it may be sort of say like this book. So this is a plane in the space. And it does not stop here. See, as the lines do not stop here, so it extends in all directions till infinity. Understand? It extends. So till now we were dealing with a one-dimensional object in a three-dimensional space, correct? So the superset, the universal set, was 3D while it was containing a 1D, one dimension, correct? Okay. Now we are dealing with planes which are 2Ds. Two dimensionals. Why? Because you can move either this way or this way in that, but not in any other way. So you'll say I can move obliquely, but that is also composed of two horizontal movements, right? As you have seen in case of your Cartesian planes. So okay, so that is 2D. This 3D could also contain another 3D. So maybe there could be a sphere or a cylinder or a parallelepiped or a cone or whatever, okay, any random object, fine. So from a 1D we are moving to a 2D, okay, but our space which contains it still remains a 3D, you understand that, okay. So we are dealing with planes, not airplanes, okay. So planes, these are 2D objects, okay. Now there are three ways in which again you define a plane to be unique, okay. A unique plane can be defined in three ways. One of the first ways to define a plane is to know the normal to the plane and its distance from the origin is given. So you know the first way is to the normal to the plane vector and is given and the distance of the plane plane from the origin is given of the plane from the origin is given, okay. That is one of the ways. So what happens? I give you a vector, say this vector, which is normal to the plane. So immediately everything that moves perpendicular to it, right? Like this. All planes which are perpendicular to it, yeah, to which this vector is perpendicular, will go like that, right? They'll go like that. Now the moment you say that the distance from the origin gets fixed, so if this is the origin, the distance you fix, and the distance will be this only. But why? Because this is perpendicular. So this will be the least distance. You understand? The distance along the normal will be the least distance. We understand that? So the moment you define the distance, it becomes unique. You understand? The moment we define the distance, it simply becomes unique. Okay? So or we have this is actually called the normal form. This is the normal form of the equation of the plane, okay. Or I can also do this, the same thing. The normal is given and it also passes through a point, okay. So here the normal was given and the distance was given from the origin, Now what we are saying, we are specifying a point through which it will pass. So you know, so I'm given this, I'll keep on sliding it till it passes through that point and that becomes unique. Okay. So again the same thing, the normal to the plane is given,
the normal to the plane is given and a fixed point through which it passes is given or known. Okay, is given. Okay.
Or the third form is, it passes through three non-collinear points. Okay.
The third is, it passes through three non-collinear points.
See, why are we insisting on the points to be non-collinear? Because if they were collinear, suppose there are three points and my plane passes through it. So just see all these planes will pass through it. So it will not become unique. Correct? It will not become unique. So if you give 10 collinear points, it does not matter. You are still not defining it uniquely. So to define it uniquely, so suppose these three fingers of mine, they are the position vectors. What happens? A plane which rests on this, like a tripod, right? They act like a tripod, and the plane which touches all these three points, like this, okay? Like this. This becomes a unique plane. So that's why we have specifically given this, we have given through three non-collinear points. You understand? If the three points were collinear, they'll all lie on this line and I'll have so many planes. So it's as good as not giving three points. It's as good as giving only two points. Correct? So these are the three forms that we'll be dealing with. And we come to the first form right now. So
the first form is, as we have said, is the normal form. Okay?
This is the normal form. And say it is something like this.
So let me draw the Cartesian space.
So it is something like this. Okay? And
it is something like this.
Obviously, I have shown the plane only in an octant, okay? Only in the positive XYZ octant. Otherwise, this plane will be moving all the way, everywhere. Okay? It is extended everywhere till infinity. So this is not the boundary of the plane, but just to understand, I'm trying to show it like this. Okay, so it is something like this. Okay, you understand? So it is some transparent kind of thing that you can see. Now see what happens. So it is something like this. The plane is something like this. It is something like this, and this is the normal. Okay, this is the normal, and the distance given is d. So I'll just explain.
The unit normal to the plane is n cap.
Okay, it is n cap. Fine. The unit normal is n cap. What else? And that is, maybe I show it like this.
So So it comes like this, okay, pierces this and goes out like that.
I don't know, you'll have to understand it in 3D if you are able to get it. So it comes from there and this makes an angle of 90 degree obviously with the plane. Okay, so it is like this, see, so it is like this, this is my origin. So the vector comes like this, it pierces it and goes out. Okay, this is my normal vector. This can be given as n cap or it can be given as capital N, say maybe any vector, okay, the vector. But here I am considering that it is n cap. If it is not n cap, if it is n without the cap, then you can make it n cap, divided by its own magnitude. Okay, so there is no trouble. So it might be given, it might not be. Now you see, if this is dn cap, this is n cap. Okay, so it is like this. Okay, now what happens, what is dn cap vector? Just try to understand the unit vector. So this is my origin, this is my origin, this point is my origin. I have a n cap vector in this direction. I have the distance, so I say the distance from the origin to the plane is equal to d. Dhyan dijiyega, okay, just be attentive. It is d, the distance is d. This is n cap. Now you know this n cap could be floating anywhere, but I have the capacity to pull it and bring its tail to the origin. Why? Because this is a free vector. So I have done exactly that. So don't get confused with what if n cap is floating somewhere 200 miles away from the plane. It can be, but you can pull it. Okay, so it is that, and the moment I multiply it with d, what happens? It goes and touches my plane. Why? Because the distance, what is dn cap? What is the length of dn cap? It is the length of n cap multiplied by d. Length of n cap is 1. So length of dn cap is what?
D.
And the moment it is d, this vector, since the distance is d, it will go and touch the plane here. Do we understand that? So dn cap is a vector whose tail is at origin and whose head just touches the plane. We understand? So dn cap vector has its tail at the origin, okay, at the origin, and its head just touches the plane, correct? Now think. So I have got this blue vector which is just touching the plane like that, right? So it is like that. Now I also have the r vector, okay? So r vector is like what? It is like it's from the origin and somewhere on the plane. What is r vector? R is a general point. R vector x, y, z is any general point. So you understand?
You understand? So x, y, z is any general point here on the plane. Okay, this is x, y, z on the plane.
And I have to relate this general point such that it lies on the plane. Okay, that's what we have done in the straight line. I have to enforce some condition on this general point such that it always keeps on hovering on the plane. Okay, so now understand, this is the r vector. So I'll again show you. My dn cap is this perpendicular vector which just touches the plane. Okay, this is, this red pen, this is my r vector, okay, whose tip is again on the plane itself. So I have two vectors whose heads are just touching the plane. Do you understand that? One is r vector, another is dn cap vector. So I say r vector also has its tail at the origin and its head just touches the plane, correct? So I have two vectors. Now what is r minus dn cap vector then?
Therefore, r minus dn cap vector lies in the plane.
You understand? See, this is my n cap, this is my r. R minus dn cap vector is a vector whose head is at r and whose tail is at, whose head is at the head of the r and whose tail is at the head of the dn cap. And since both these heads lie on the plane itself, they touch the plane, hence r minus dn cap is a vector that lies in the plane. Do you understand? Now r minus dn cap, so it is this kind of a vector which lies in the plane. Okay, this is lying in the plane. And obviously any vector that lies in the plane has to be perpendicular to the dn cap, is it not? All the vectors lying in the plane, they may be anything. Okay, because what has happened? My dn cap, yeah, n cap is perpendicular to the plane everywhere on the plane. Everywhere it is perpendicular. So all the vectors lying on the plane, they have to become perpendicular to my n cap or dn cap, whatever you like to say. I say n cap. Okay, now r minus dn cap is perpendicular to n cap. Now if two vectors are perpendicular, their dot product has to be, so r minus dn cap dotted with n cap has to be 0. Okay, see, I can also write dn cap here, then I'll have to cancel that d. Okay, so that gives me, since the dot product is distributive, so r dot n cap minus d n cap dot n cap is equal to 0. And what is n cap dot n cap? Mod n cap, which is 1, into mod n cap, which is again 1, into cos of the angle between them. What is the angle between n cap and n cap? 0. Between two vectors, there is no angle, 0 angle. So cos 0. So 1 into 1 into
1. So I'll write it maybe for your convenience. So minus d into mod n cap cos 0 degrees is equal to 0. So this gives me 1 into 1 into 1. So 1 into 1 into 1. So r dot n cap minus d is equal to 0. R dot n cap minus d.